On Acoustic Tuesday, episode number 66, you're going to find out the secret to learning and incorporating any guitar lick into your playing almost immediately. You're going to hear a modern-day blues master and get the definitive guitar geek guide for all of your holiday shopping needs. All that and more right after this.
If you believe that playing acoustic guitar is about sharing the joy of music with friends and family, not just mastering the technical side of playing, then this show is your dream come true. Every Tuesday morning, I give you my list of exciting guitar geek discoveries, gear, and new music so you can stay inspired to live your best acoustic life. I'm Tony Polecastro, and this is the Acoustic Tuesday Show. Guitar geeks, unite.
Welcome to Acoustic Tuesday, episode number 66. This is the show where you're going to learn about acoustic guitar gear, discover acoustic artists, and get inspired to live your very best acoustic life. As with all episodes of Acoustic Tuesday, I'm going to share with you my guitar geek list for the week. And let me tell you, this week, I've got a jam-packed list for you. There's a lesson in here. There's a really cool piece of gear in here for you. And an artist that you simply need to know about. I didn't hear about him before, but now that one of our Acoustic Tuesday viewers chimed in, I have heard of this man, and let me tell you, holy smokes, you're going to be impressed. But before I dive into all this guitar geeky goodness, I have to introduce you to royalty, ladies and gentlemen. Sir Noah Jacob Heckman Jr. is on hand. He is mustache-less, and I will let him tell you the story of why that mustache no longer exists.
Fine. Mustache and beard trimming, I think, is a lost art. And I, being one who was able to grow facial hair later in life, I never acquired the skill. And so I tried. I tried to do the trimming. It wasn't happening. It just kept getting smaller and smaller, and each time was more uneven and off. And then before I know it, it was gone. But then something very telling, right after it was gone and my wife came out and saw me, pretty much the first words out of her mouth was, "Oh, there's my handsome husband that I, you know and love." So it's like, so the truth comes out. You never liked it, did you? You didn't? Irish warrior? Fine. So that's the story, Tony. It wasn't that amusing.
Well, I think you look handsome either way, Noah.
Thank you.
I think you look, I had quite a mishap as well. Apparently, now I love Whitney so much. Oh, my, one of my shining guys fell down. I love Whitney so much.
I know.
And she does the lion's share of the house stuff. Mm-hmm. And she does a great job. She got a hold of my favorite flannel. Noah, I got room on the, I have no room on these sleeves.
What happened?
Well, I think it went into the dryer. So it's kind of, or I'm getting larger. I don't know. Apparently I might be gaining a few ounces.
I
don't know how that's even possible. But hey.
I wasn't going to go that direction.
Well, let's put our mishaps behind us and have a great show today, shall we?
Yeah, we're going to start new. We're going to go lay back down in the bed and get back up.
That's right.
Yes.
That's Noah's secret. If you're having a bad day, you literally take yourself physically, you go back to bed, lay down and get up again, start over. He does that with the kids. He shared that with me a couple mornings when I was having a rough one.
Yeah.
But today I want to dig right into a little bit of lesson, a little bit of teaching rather that I want to I think everybody should know, because there's a problem that exists in guitar geek land, and that is we are hungry to learn guitar licks. We are hungry to learn guitar licks, and we do so at breakneck speed. But there's this huge hurdle in integrating those licks within our playing. I know I ran into it and still run into it where I'm like, I learned this lick and all of a sudden I'm like, cool. Well, I know this cool little thing, but how does it work in my playing? And then pretty soon it just ends up staying a lick and it doesn't really end up being integrated into your playing. And that's what we're going to solve right now, because I want to share with you, get this, the lick learning method. This is something Noah and I came up with. And I want you to be able to learn a lick and then incorporate it into your playing. So I want you to use this LIP method. And let me explain what that stands for. L-I-P, right? The first is you need to learn the lick. The second step is you need to identify the time window that it takes up. And last but certainly not least, you need to practice the lick in context. okay? So you have to learn the lick, you have to identify the time window, and you have to practice the lick in context. Now, let me quickly go over this with you. So I'm gonna use the classic bluegrass G run as an example here. So for those of you who aren't familiar with it, let me just play it really quick. It sounds like this. You've probably heard it before and just not realized it was the bluegrass G run. It sounds like this. Right, so that's the lick. And if you learn that, that's cool, but what if you can't incorporate that into your playing? That poses a problem, and that's what we're gonna fix, okay? So the first things first, you have to learn the lick. And there's no shortcuts here. You just have to sit down and get familiar with the lick itself, okay? Realize where the notes are, and then incorporate the timing. Okay, and I think the problem here, and a lot of times we run into a wall right off the bat because we want the lick to sound just like the lick on our first or second try. Well, let's just take a step back and just ease into it step by step, right? First of all, get familiar with where the notes are, okay? You don't have to play it in time right off the bat. Just get familiar with where the notes are. And then once you get familiar with where the notes are, how to fret them, then start to play it in time, right? So if you're learning the bluegrass G run and this is your first attempt, that's okay, right? You're just getting familiar with the real estate, where the notes are. Once you get familiar with where the notes are, then you can introduce the actual proper timing to it, okay? So that's just learning the lick. Once you have the lick learned, then you have to identify the time window. How much time the lick takes up. This is crucial to incorporate it in your playing. For example, this bluegrass G run, if I count along with it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So it takes up a full measure, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. It takes up one full measure. That's what I'm talking about by understanding the timing window. Once you understand how much time, how much space it takes up musically, then you can plan for it in your playing, okay? So that's identifying the timing window. You've learned the lick step by step. You've identified the timing window, how much time it actually takes up when playing it. And the last thing to do is practice it in context. And let me explain what that is. I want you to actually practice the lick while playing rhythm guitar. Okay, what does that mean? Well, that means you're just maintaining a steady, nice, steady rhythm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then incorporating the lick into that. So that practicing it in context not only reinforces the lick itself, but it also gets you used to using it the way that it's supposed to be used, right? And the key part is to bookend it with solid rhythm. We know the lick takes up one measure. So if we maintain a good solid boom chicka rhythm, 1, 2, 3, 4, we know that we can plug that particular lick into one measure and then go right back into our rhythm again. Just like I did, I'll count along with it this time. I'll do a kind of a condensed version just so you can kind of get an idea of this whole idea of timing, right? So I'll start out with one measure of rhythm, do the lick, and then go back to rhythm. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And you can go ahead and repeat that for as long as you wish. But that's the three-step method for actually incorporating a lick into your playing. You gotta learn the lick, identify the time window, the actual time that it takes up musically, and then you have to practice it in context. Now, I know you might be sitting there wondering, Tony, can you just show me how to play the lick? Well, yes, I don't wanna take up the whole show in showing you how to play that exact lick, but good news. If you go to acousticlife.tv/AT66, you'll be able to learn that very lick and go through the process in much more detail. So please check that out if you want to learn that lick and how to incorporate it into your playing. I think you'll be very, very excited once you learn it and actually start using it in your playing. Again, just go to acousticlife.tv/AT66 and you can check out that full lesson in deep detail. And If you want to take your playing to the next level, if you like learning licks, you got to check out Tony's Acoustic Challenge. Just go to tonysacousticchallenge.com. You can learn more about the program, everything involved. And if it's something, if it's a direction that you want to take your playing, if the information resonates with you, I want you to request your invite today. And you can do that at tonysacousticchallenge.com. All right, now moving on to very important business here at Acoustic Tuesday. We have Guitar Geek Trivia to deal with. So, well, we don't have to deal with it. It's just a fun thing that I like to do because I like trivia. I know Noah likes trivia, and we're just going to do trivia right now. Here's your Guitar Geek Trivia question. Prior to building his own high-end acoustic guitars, Kevin Kopp worked in the custom shop of what major guitar manufacturer? Was it A, Gibson, B, Martin, C, Taylor, or D, Fender? Go ahead and ponder that, and at the end of the show, I'll be sure to give you the answer. Now, I want to turn things over to Noah because I know he's been scrubbing through past episodes, digging up shout-outs, digging up comments, witty remarks. Noah, you've got it all over there. Can you share some of those with us?
Sure have. Wow, we're already doing comments.
I know.
Man, that teaching segment just flew by.
It kind of did. I hope I covered things.
Yeah.
Well, if I went too fast, again, you can go to acousticlife.tv/AT66, and there's a much more detailed, maybe slower-paced lesson. Could be the coffee you made this morning, too.
Maybe. I like how it was on me and you just... it's an adventure every time. I love it.
I'm sorry.
Do you like how I started using the Celtic mug?
Noah did this ancestry report. He did this, what is it called, the 23andMe?
Yeah.
And he found out he was like Irish and Scottish and something, and now he's connected to royalty all of a sudden, so he comes in with a goblet now. now he's like, he's speaking in tongues and he does the goblet.
I feel like I finally know who I am. It's like I've been living a lie so many years, and now I finally know. All right. So on to comments from Acoustic Tuesday viewers from past episodes. First one comes from Andy D. He says, thanks Tony and Noah for inspiring me every week to continue on this journey of learning guitar. Acoustic Tuesday is my weekday guitar church service, but I would love to see an episode where you two switch places. Tony is the amusing sidekick and Noah is the engaging expert host. But that'd be more than a small win. I brought that up to you earlier, Tony, and your reply wasn't very favorable.
Well, here's my concern. I mean, if I can be just totally honest and transparent.
Yeah, we're transparent.
I am about the worst when it comes to technology. So having both Levi and Noah help with actual technology allows me to function in my day-to-day life.
That's valid.
I mean, it's a real problem.
That's valid.
If I didn't need my phone, I would have thrown it into the ocean when we were surfing.
That's valid. Okay. I understand. Shall I move on?
You shall.
Okay.
I'm not going to interrupt.
All right.
Yet.
Next shout out goes to Carl W., who says, hi, guys. I'm a new subscriber to your channel, watching from Manchester in England, which is great.
Awesome.
My ancestors are from the United Kingdom. And loving your banter and features. Keep up the good work. All the best, Carl.
Any chance he gets.
Yes. Any chance I get. Next shout out goes to Peter M. Tony, from a Maryland boy, you pronounced Hagerstown perfectly this time.
Yes.
You make me want to run out there from Baltimore, however, and pick up a resonator from your resonator crash course that you that you did. Next shout out goes to Don. He says, didn't know much about resonator guitars, but now I do. Thanks for such an interesting show.
Oh, cool.
And like the theme show format.
Nice.
From Boston, Massachusetts as
Very
well.
Very cool.
And Kabayoth says, he threw in a hashtag sage advice with Noah. And he says, drummers get the best girlfriends. Bassists have the best stories. Makes sense, my ancestry.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Fiddlers have all the best tunes. Banjo players have the most fun. Guitarists have the most competition.
Oh.
Get them playing together, and everyone has the best of times.
I like that. That's good.
Yeah.
Sage advice with Noah. I like that. We need like a backdrop with like a cliff and like a sunset coming up, you know?
Yes.
Or a sunrise coming up.
I was going to say like coat of arms. Right?
Are you done?
Okay. Next shout out goes to Maggie P. Says, good stuff, guys. Now I want a resonator guitar.
Heck yeah.
And next, Mark H says, loving AT on Wednesdays in Baghdad. Another vet out there serving and awesome. Enjoying himself with Acoustic Tuesday. Thank you for Heck serving. Yeah. And the last shout out goes to Pedro M. He says, thanks for the show, guys. Tuning in from Uppsala, Sweden.
Whoa.
And this show is a must every week.
Oh, wow. Thanks for tuning in. That's awesome.
And there you go.
Cool shout outs. Well, thank you.
You're very welcome.
Appreciate it, Noah.
You're welcome.
The next item comes from an Acoustic Tuesday viewer. Cedric P. from London, England, actually submitted this at acousticlife.tv. He submitted this artist recommendation. Now, this is an artist that I had heard the name, but I actually just I never sat down to listen to the music. And I feel almost embarrassed to admit that, because once I sat down and listened to the music, I was like, why? I was missing out, essentially. And Cedric P. wanted us to listen to Eric Bibb, and we listened to Eric Bibb, and this is what Cedric says about Eric Bibb. Eric Bibb is quite simply one of the most prolific acoustic singer-songwriter bluesmen in the world today. Last year, his album Migration Blues was nominated for a Grammy alongside the Rolling Stones' Lonesome and Blue album in the blues category. I don't represent Eric, I'm just a fan, but for those of us who work in the music industry and have come across him, we're constantly in awe of his tone, guitar work, and songwriting narrative. Most importantly, his new album, Global Griot, spelled G-R-I-O-T. Now, Noah's going to reveal the definition for this because he's a geek, and we looked it up. Do you want to go ahead and let us know what that means? Griot, spelled G-R-I-O-T.
Absolutely. I would love to, Tony.
What does it mean? Because I almost said griot. I was going on the riot end of things, but just a G in front of it.
I think you said it like any possible way it could have been said.
Griote.
So griot is a noun. Mm-hmm. A member of a class of traveling poets, musicians, and storytellers who maintain a tradition of oral history in parts of West Africa.
Oh, very cool.
That's very specific.
So, most importantly, his new album, Global Griot, was released this week, encompassing an inclusive world acoustic culture, proving that music truly is universal, and there is no greater friend to it than the acoustic guitar. So we dug into Eric Bibb last week as we were kind of going through and setting up for the show today. And I'll tell you what, I am way impressed. Vocals, guitar work, pretty much Cedric nailed it. His command of the guitar, it looks almost effortless. And that's, he just gets lost in the moment. And not to mention, he is a dapper, dapper dresser. I mean, every picture I've seen, he's got a different suit and it looks so good. Anyways, let's actually listen to Eric Bibb play a tune called Going Down Slow.
If I don't get well no more, people, I done had my fun. If I don't get well no more, my health is failing me. I'm going down slow. Would you ride my mother? Tell her the shape I'm in. Would you ride my mother? Oh, tell her the shape I'm in. Tell her to pray for me. Forgive me for my sins. I don't need no
I think what I admire the most about Eric is the completeness of him just sitting down with a guitar and singing. Vocally, awesome. His playing is so distinct. I mean, I love that when he's singing, he can maintain good solid rhythm, but then in those little spaces, he provides fills that are just so tasty, so rhythmic, so melodic, and it's just back into singing again. It's just effortless, and I love seeing that. So Eric Bibb is certainly a player that you need to know about. Now, he's got a whole slew of albums out there, but I've picked out five that I think I think are pretty darn awesome. The first one is Booker's Guitar. That one has a whole story. You have to check that one out. Blues, Ballads, and Work Songs is another. Third one I want to mention is Blues People. And the next two are Cedric both mentioned in his write-up. He said this first one, Migration Blues, that one was up for a Grammy. And then, of course, Eric's newest release, Global Griot. And we are all better now for knowing the definition of that as well. So make sure to check out Eric Bibb. And I want to thank Cedric for recommending him. And if you have an artist that you want to see featured on Acoustic Tuesday, please head over to acousticlife.tv. There's a submit link in the top menu, and you can submit an artist for consideration for a future show. And I have to thank you all, because you all have really brought up some amazing artists. So I appreciate you all who have submitted and have taken the time to do that. It's pretty awesome how many amazing artists are out there that, you know, are unknown to a lot of us. So keep those submissions coming. Now, I want to move on, because I've got a really cool stomp box that I want to share with you all. But I want to check the mailbag first. Got some really interesting arrivals. Noah actually got an arrival this week, and I think that in and of itself is interesting. But first, can I share what I got in the mailbag?
Sure, yours is better. Anyway.
So I got this really cool card featuring a goalie and an RMCP officer playing hockey. And it's clearly from Canada. The back says the most Canadian photo ever. But it's from Kara Luft from the Small Glories, who played at the Acoustic Life Festival back in June 2018. And she just was actually sharing some wonderful thoughts about the festival and thanking us for having her. And she knew that I played hockey, so she went ahead and sent that, which I thought was pretty darn cool. So I want to thank Kara for taking time out to send that card. That picture was actually taken, she says this in the card, right where her tiny home is parked. I mean, her tiny home is not in the mountain range, but it's near the mountain range where that was taken.
Nice.
I thought that was pretty cool.
Yeah.
And then next, we got a really kind letter from Rob C. And I'll do my best to summarize it and kind of read the selections. This is just a perfect letter for this time of year, being that Thanksgiving just happened and kind of having all those warm fuzzies of community and everything. So Rob C. says, hello from Maryland and occasionally D.C. Hello to Tony, Noah, and Levi. After watching the inaugural pre-AT live stream last night, with apparently many of my TAC Jam group friends on hand, and in the spirit of the upcoming Thanksgiving holiday, I just wanted to take a moment to thank you all. For what, you may ask? Well, when I joined TAC in late October of 2017, all I expected at the time was to gain a new approach to learning how to play guitar, and the daily bite-sized structure that TAC offers in its weekday lessons, and some theory with Fretboard Wizard, really truly appealed to me, as did the Academy. Yet little did I know then how much more TAC would contribute to my life, not just the musical one. I may not likely join the pantheon of great players, but I can count myself a card-carrying member in the community of guitar geeks, and that is genuinely fulfilling enough. But I've also gained more than some new chords and licks. Meeting and making new friends, joining jam groups, and enjoying evenings out to concerts together with other like-minded TAC members, including I'm With Her, which as I write this is coming up next week in Philly, with Dom and Sharon Tiano, are among the many things that truly make TAC the acoustic community. Added to this is being introduced to any number of great luthiers through the Acoustic Letter, Music Villa, Eddie's Guitars, and of course the incomparable Ask Matt Chalka, who recently sent me a Martin Custom Shop 00018, because he's like that, and because he ran my credit card. You've also given me gas and helped expand my guitar arsenal to my wife's and bank account's chagrin. Learn of many new useful products, say yes to SC Parabolic Low Tensions, support G4V, and of course experience Acoustic Tuesday, which simply adds icing to an already impressive cake. And Rob goes on to just kind of really kind of share how much this whole community and Acoustic Tuesday and Tony's Acoustic Challenge has impacted his life. And he was saying how Acoustic Tuesday has introduced him to so many amazing artists. And he said now it's his time to return the favor. So he sent along a CD by Michael Cobrin, his CD Alive. And I'm going to dig into this. He recommended two tracks off of this album. It's the CD is entitled Alive, and he recommended we listen to the tracks The Middle East and Rhodes. So I'm going to do that, and we'll keep our eyes peeled for a future Acoustic Tuesday episode that this may very well make an appearance again. So I want to thank Rob C. for taking time out to send such a kind letter and share his thoughts and thanks. And I want to thank Rob C. For the letter, but also all of you for being a part of such an amazing community. Now, along with this letter and CD, Noah received something that he's been working on. He wants to show you all.
Yeah. It's something I need to be working on. Thank you, Rob, for saying it. He said, Noah, to the man keeping the beat on AT, thought you could use this to accompany Tony as he plays. And so Rob sent me a Snoopy's harp, a jaw harp. And I was trying to read the directions about how to do this, and it's going to take some work because right now this is about all I can get. Not very impressive. So I'm going to practice that and then come back later on and just wow you with my skills.
I'm excited for that jam session.
Yeah, it's going to be real good.
Well, Noah, it will be a small win when you finally are able to produce some noise with that.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of small wins,
yes,
that's my attempt at a transition in the small win segment. Shall we celebrate?
No, you transitioned. Let's do it. All right. Always one of my favorite parts of Acoustic Tuesday, sharing viewer small wins. First one comes up from Ryan C. And he says, small win, thanks to Tony and all the great videos on Acoustic Life. I am beginning to understand the fretboard, and I played my first bar chord yesterday with zero buzzing.
Heck yeah.
Thank y'all for your promotion of everything acoustic guitar.
Awesome, man. Thanks. That's a great win.
And the next one comes from Frank M., whose small win is a hashtag new guitar day.
Oh. He
says, for my 50th birthday, I spoiled myself with a 2018 D35. Always a small body guy. I played it without looking. Presence and big personality. My first made in Nazareth Martin.
Awesome.
And then I have a Dread Junior, and I built a copy of an early 20th century 12 fret triple O.
Very cool.
The thinner bracing is beautiful for finger style and strumming, and such a sharp looking guitar. Going with some friends to Nazareth to meet the makers sometime soon.
Heck yeah, congratulations. That's an awesome guitar.
I like that whole meet the maker thing.
Yeah.
And then our final small win for today comes from Chance W., who says, small win, getting turned on to people like Toby Walker, Tim Stafford, Benjamin Todd, Lost Dog Street Band is his huge win.
Oh, that's awesome. That is way cool.
Which falls right in line with what Rob was just saying in the letter.
Absolutely.
I think we sometimes, you know, like how we think there are certain aspects of the show that we think will really stand out.
Yeah.
And I think one of the most surprising parts has been the introduction of new artists for people.
Yeah. There are so many amazing players. And all the comments really, kind of point to that too. Everybody's like, man, hearing these new artists is fantastic. And I got to say, it's fantastic for us as well because those submissions keep us on our toes. We get tons of submissions for artists, and it's fun to listen to new music. I think it's easy to fall into a rut with that. I mean, Noah generally plays the same thing at the office pretty much every day. So it's nice for you guys to keep submitting those so I can break Noah out of his rut.
I go through phases, okay? I don't get in a rut. I go through phases.
I'm kidding. I'm sorry.
And now it's all Celtic music.
Yeah, since Noah got his ancestry report, mm-hmm. Now all we're listening to is Celtic music.
That's
because
right.
Noah, apparently one of his ancestors was probably a fiddle player, some Celtic band somewhere.
And a leprechaun.
Yeah, after he was a king in some other foreign land. Who knows? Noah has woven some pretty interesting tales.
Well, I can't wait to see yours. So
I'm concerned.
That's going to be a fun day.
Well, I would like to share a small win as well. This is less of a guitar-related small win, although it impacts my guitar playing in terms of lyric recollection because I'm very tired right now.
Oh,
if y'all can see the bags under my eyes, I just want to first apologize for that. And I tried to play a little guitar this morning, and I couldn't remember anything, which was frustrating, but it's because I'm exhausted. Why am I exhausted? Well, this weekend, I played a hockey tournament, which essentially, for those of you non-hockey folks out there, it's just a lot of hockey in a condensed period of time. We had a game Friday night, bright and early Saturday morning, Saturday afternoon, bright and early Sunday morning, and then I subbed for a game on Sunday night. So I had five games over the weekend, and then I had a game just this morning as well. So a lot of hockey, and I'm kind of pooped, but good news. My team won the tournament, and I've got photographic evidence. Okay, I've got the team picture with the trophy.
Okay, got that.
And then I've got my little moment with the wood stick cup. This is a tournament that only allows wooden hockey sticks, which is a thing of the past now, but that's what I grew up playing anyway. But it was a fun weekend, but I'm paying the price right now because I can barely function. My voice is about ready to be
toast. Did you not take a puck to the face this morning?
Mm-hmm. In fact, my headache is just going away. And I looked at my mask as I put it in my bag, and there's a huge chip off of the chin, like a bunch of paint came off. So That's just the life of a goalie. It's what happens. But it was a fun weekend nonetheless, and I just wanted to share that with you all because, I don't know, it was a small win.
It's a great win.
Yeah, it's awesome. Moving along, I want to introduce you all to a stomp box. Okay, not an effects stomp box, an actual stomp box. Called the Wazinator. Now remember that name. It's hard to forget. The Wazinator, okay? Wazinator stomp boxes are made in Australia, and they are awesome. Now you might be thinking, okay, a stomp box, like you step on it, it makes noise. How can there be good and bad stomp boxes? Well, first of all, I've tried out quite a few of these because I've wanted to feature one on the show for some time, but I haven't found one that really floats my boat. Because they have a tendency to sound a little bit clicky and not very musical. Like they just kind of make a tap and it just doesn't have any body to it. That is not the case with the Wazinator. The Wazinator, now this is the classic model, more on the different models here in a second, but this is a plywood base with what essentially is a speaker diaphragm right here and a little chamber of compressed air in it. So when you tap on this, you plug this into your PA, and it gives the most musical kind of thumpy bass. So if you're playing any sort of song and you're just looking for that subtle accompaniment to just drive the rhythm, this is a great option. Again, this is the classic model. Now, this was introduced in 2005. Yeah, since 2005, and fully analog, fully dynamic, meaning there's no batteries or anything. You just plug this puppy in. Totally passive, and in terms of being dynamic, the harder you hit it, the more thump you get, the more subtle you hit it, the less thump you get. So it's really reactive to how you hit it. Now, Wazinator makes actually three different models, but first let's actually listen to the classic so you can see how it functions and how it sounds. Some pretty suave red leather Converse shoes in there, if I might add. Now, that again, the classic is probably, I would say, one of the most common models. It's got some great, it's got no slip rubber grip. It comes with a really cool neoprene bag for gigging and takes up a pretty large chunk of the stage. So that's what brings me to the next model, which is the Dropkick. Now, the Dropkick is the world's first alloy, what is it? It's an alloy die-cast aluminum stomp box. So the pedal of it is made of an alloy aluminum, or a die-cast aluminum, and it has kind of a rounded off heel, so it's a little bit more ergonomic, so your foot doesn't get tired. It has a little wooden spot on the top, same idea as this, totally passive, totally analog, and it sounds pretty cool as well. It sounds different, so actually let's listen to that one as well. All right, so that's the Dropkick. Now, last but certainly not least, this next one is for the guitarist that really just wants to throw something to make some extra thump in their guitar case, right? If you don't, obviously you can't fit this in your guitar case, although I will say this one offers the sweetest tone, in my opinion. The Baby Grand model from Wazenator can actually fit in your guitar case and give you that thump, and all it needs is, it's the same as all of these, it's just a simple guitar cable to plug into the PA or a bass amp. Actually, bass amp gives you a little bit better effect. So let's have a listen to the Baby Grand, the smallest of all the Wazenator stomp boxes. All right, so there you have it. Full lineup of all the Wazenator stomp boxes. Now, these are made by Warwick Porter out of Australia, as I mentioned, and I'm telling you, just in listening to him speak about his product, he is passionate about these, and it really shows in the quality of the tone you get, the actual quality of something you're going to be stepping on. I mean, these are built like tanks, and they sound so good. Like I said, I've tried a bunch of these because I've wanted to feature them on the show before, but I just haven't found one that really gives a good, solid, like, hits you in your gut kind of a thump, and these very much do. So please check these out. You can go to acousticlife.tv/AT66, and you'll be able to see those three models, a little comparison video on those, and there's also, very importantly, there's buy links for each of those at acousticlife.tv/AT66. And remember, any link you see on acousticlife.tv, those are affiliate links for Amazon. We get a percentage of those sales, but the good news is that we pass that percentage, all of it, directly to Guitars for Vets as a donation on behalf of you guitar geeks. So if you're ever thinking about any of these products on Acoustic Life or on Acoustic Tuesday, head over to acousticlife.tv, use those buy links, and by using those, you'll make a small donation to Guitars for Vets as well. All right, I wanna know what you think about the show. So please, in the comments below, let us know, say hi, let us know where you're tuning in from. And of course, while you're doing that, if you haven't done so yet, please, please subscribe to this YouTube channel. It's super easy, hit that red subscribe button. Don't forget to hit that little gray bell. That'll give you a notification of each and every new video that gets released. And you'll be kept in the loop, of course. And if you want Acoustic Tuesday delivered directly to your email, that's super easy. There's a link in the description. And this way, that will ensure that you never, ever miss a show. Now, I know that Noah has combed through previous shows' comments, but he also has pulled some very special, we'll call these top shelf comments, that you know you're a guitar geek when. Much like a top shelf bourbon. Delicious, smooth.
Okay.
That's what these comments are.
Yeah.
Okay, that's all I get. Okay.
Well, when you said top shelf comments, I thought you were thinking of like the sage advice from Noah comments.
No, these are different.
Yeah. yeah, I got two of them for you today, Tony.
All right.
First one comes from Kay Bayoth, who said, you know you're a guitar geek when you're in Chicago for a business trip and you pretty much almost become depressed because you never made it to the Chicago Music Exchange.
That is a depression-worthy moment.
I understand. And then our other one comes from Diorman R, who says, you know you're a guitar geek when Sir Noah Jacob Heckman Jr. the First mentions you on YouTube.
High honors.
You like how indeed. I chose that one?
Oh, I like how you chose that one, and it holds even more weight now because Noah, his ancestors were royal. They were royal people.
That's right.
So it's like a declaration from a king almost.
Wow. That's that's heavy. That's almost too much. I need a moment.
Well, we have some more. We actually have heard from more guitar geeks, and some folks submitted guitar arsenal pictures. So you got to see these guitar arsenals from our Acoustic Tuesday viewers. I'll tell you how to submit yours if you haven't done so yet. But first up, we've got Bruce M. from Anthem, Arizona. Now, check this out. First of all, I want to live in Bruce's house because that's the room I would probably never leave. Hopefully, there's a bathroom off of that room because I would never leave that room, ever. Bruce has an extremely impressive collection of guitars. He says he's got 41 guitars, too numerous to list, but he'll post the best of the best. So this is what he chose. He's got a Guild D140 CE, a Gibson Everly Brothers from 1964, that's awesome, an Ovation Standard Elite 2778 AX, a Fender Stratocaster Standard, a D'Angelico Premier Madison, a Godin 57th Avenue Archtop, a Martin DCX1E, a Martin D16 RGT, a Taylor T5 Custom, a Gibson CL10 from 1996, a Seagull Maritime SWSCW, a Gibson Songwriter Deluxe BC Studio, a Taylor 214 CE Sunburst Deluxe, a Taylor 516 CE Symphony, a PRS Marty Friedman Electric, an Epiphone Les Paul Ultra 3, a Gibson J15, a Blue Ridge BR183A, a Gibson Hummingbird Pro, a Larivee 40MT 000 Legacy, an Ibanez Artcore Expressionist AG950QA, and a Blue Ridge BR70AS. I'm just going to take a second after that guitar arsenal. Felt like an auctioneer that didn't go to auctioneer school, which is actually exactly what I am.
You're really good.
Yeah.
You've gotten really good at that.
That was good. I mean, for the level of, I mean, I'm going on 4 hours of sleep right now. So that's pretty, well, it's better than sometimes when I have 8 hours of sleep. Moving on. Next guitar arsenal is a global guitar arsenal from Manuelo S. from, hopefully I say this right, I'm going to try my best, Curitiba, Brazil. Manuelo says, I'm from Curitiba, Brazil, and passing by to say thank you guys very much for your show. It's been a huge incentive to me. I use music as a way to worship and express myself. I have in the picture a Cort CJ10, his companion for 10 years, a Gibson SJ200, a Gibson Western Classic Supreme, that is a stunner, a Martin D28 Marquis, another beautiful guitar, a Taylor 814 CE Deluxe V-Class, which he's currently using the ToneWrite device on, and last but not least, a 1967 Del Vecchio, all Brazilian rosewood. So a big hug from South Brazil to you guys, and please keep doing what you're doing. Absolutely, Manuelo. Thanks for submitting your guitar arsenal. And if you're sitting there thinking, you know what? I have a guitar arsenal I want to share with these guitar geeks. Please do. We need more guitar arsenals from everybody. It doesn't matter the size. It could be a small guitar arsenal. It could be just the start of your guitar arsenal. It could be a guitar arsenal that you've been building for years and years and years. Any way, shape, or form, we want to see it. So number one, get yourself a guitar arsenal shirt. There's a link right beneath the YouTube video. Number two, put that guitar arsenal shirt on and go ahead and take a picture with you amongst all of your guitars. And number three, submit that picture at acousticlife.tv. Again, go to acousticlife.tv. There's a submit link right in the top menu. You'll be able to submit your picture and of course describe it so we can be all geeky about your guitars together. And that's when you know you're a true guitar geek and you've reached the pinnacle of the guitar geek mountain. You've submitted your guitar salon Acoustic Tuesday.
The summit?
You can join the ranks. You too can summit Guitar Geek Mountain. At the Guitar Geek Peak?
Guitar Geek Peak.
Guitar Geek Peak?
That's good.
Yeah. You gotta make a slow ascent though. You get the bends. Or you get oxygen poisoning or something? No. It's elevation sickness? Altitude sickness. Thanks for letting me work that out. Okay, moving on. If you want other folks to see how we work through problems here on Acoustic Tuesday, please share the show with them. But in all seriousness, if you have a guitar geek friend that you know would love Acoustic Tuesday, but they have not seen it yet, please share the show with them. You can send them a YouTube link, send them to acousticlife.tv, pick your favorite products, send it to them, just say, hey, you got to check this out. Please, please share the show with as many guitar geeks as you can, because the whole point is for us to take a second on Tuesdays and be guitar geeks together and unite as many guitar geeks as possible. So please share the show with all of your guitar geek friends. Now, speaking of guitar geek friends, this next item is very, very important because there comes a time, usually around the holidays. I'll describe the scenario because I know it well. You're a guitar geek. Right? You're a guitar geek. You own your guitar geekiness. You watch Acoustic Tuesday every single Tuesday. You love it. And it never fails. Your spouse, significant other, friend, parents, they don't know what to get you because they're intimidated by your guitar geekiness. They're like, well, I would get you a piece of gear, but I don't know as much as you know, so I don't really know what to get you, so they get you a sweater. And that's really sweet. It's a good sentiment, but it's a bummer because we don't need more sweaters. I mean, I might need a flannel, but that's maybe what I'll ask Whitney for this year. That's besides the point. We want to get guitar geek gifts, right? We're not being greedy, but you know, it's nice to receive something that you've been wanting and it's the exact right thing. So I've done it. I've made a guitar geek holiday guide gift list. Okay, you can find it at acousticlife.tv/guide, and it contains pretty much the guitar geek wish list of the century, of this year, but we'll call it the century. So when somebody asks you, hey, I know you're a guitar geek. I don't know what to get you. You just send them this link, acousticlife.tv/guide, and all of a sudden, bam, there's going to be like 50 items on there that they can pick from, and you know it's going to be a guitar geek gift that you're going to want. I mean, I'm talking a bunch of stuff. And the good thing is, everything on this list has one of those Amazon referral links. So whether you buy it for yourself or you buy it for some other guitar geek, a percentage of that sale comes to us, and then we pass that directly on to Guitars for Vets as a donation on behalf of all of you guitar geeks. So this holiday gift list is gonna be something that you're gonna want to check out. Again, go to acousticlife.tv/guide. And that will be your secret to getting through the holidays, whether you're buying for another guitar geek or you just want that special someone to get you that right special something for your guitar collection or maybe add to your guitar arsenal. So I know this is one of those sensitive topics, but I'm trying to bring us together. I'm trying to bring guitar geeks and non-guitar geeks together on the common ground of gift giving.
You know, Tony, you know what this makes me think of?
What?
It's like a registry. You know, like when people get married or something like that, it's like,
it's a guitar geek registry.
Yeah, I don't know what to get you for. It's okay. I've taken care of it. I'm registered on acousticlife.tv.
Yeah.
Go there. You'll see the geeky guitar buyers list and just choose from that.
So I got it. There's a lot of selfish motives behind this. I'm just going to be totally honest with you all. It could be the lack of sleep. It just could be. You know, I know Whitney's scared to buy me anything guitar. I know that for a fact. So I'm hoping this list will actually break down that barrier and she'll start like dipping her toe in the water, maybe like a couple of blue chip picks, maybe like a couple of the documentaries I've featured that we've rented, but I want the hard copy because I'm a dork.
Was she gonna know about this holiday buyer's guide?
Well, yeah, I'll tell her. But I'll do it in a real sly way.
I mean, because
I'll be like, man, we filmed a great show today. We got this holiday gift guide coming out. You got to check it out. It's just acousticlife.tv/guide. You can just bookmark it, sweetie.
It's like, I'm concerned, you know, because like I lived in Southern California for over 10 years and I went to Disneyland like twice. So it's almost like you're so close to the source.
Yeah.
You don't really dive in.
I get it.
Yeah.
I get it.
That's all. I'm just concerned.
Well, we're going to see how it plays out, okay. But I want you all to use it. Whether it's your best friend buying you something, your spouse, your guitar geek buddy, whatever the case may be, go to acousticlife.tv/guide. There's going to be a treasure trove of guitar goodies on there for you to sift through, mark if you want them or not, print it out, hand it to your buyer, whatever you want to do with it. Just use it as we'll call it an assist, a guitar geek assist, if you will. So that pretty much wraps up Acoustic Tuesday, episode number 66, our post-Thanksgiving Black Tuesday. Can we call? Is there such a thing as Black Tuesday?
There is now.
Is that a thing?
We made it.
Acoustic Black Tuesday?
Yeah.
It sounds so negative. I mean, cornucopia of acoustic goodness Tuesday?
That's good.
If you guys have any suggestions, please leave them in the comments below what we should call the acoustic day that happens after Thanksgiving. Just go ahead and put them in the comments. We'll read them out in a future show. But I want to thank you all for tuning in today, but we have one more item of important business, and that is your Guitar Geek Trivia Question Answer. So just to remind you, here was your Guitar Geek Trivia Question. Prior to building his own high-end acoustic guitars, Kevin Kopp worked in the custom shop of what major guitar manufacturer? Was it A, Gibson, B, Martin, C, Taylor, or D, Fender? Well, if you answered A, Gibson, you're absolutely correct. Kevin Kopp moved to Bozeman, Montana in 1992 to work for Gibson. Kevin's talents quickly moved him into the custom shop where he was able to hone his skills working with luthiers such as John Walker and master luthier Ren Ferguson. Together, they created many one-of-a-kind customized high-end Gibson guitars, or Ginches, as they came to be called. Kevin now makes world-class acoustic guitars under his own name here in Bozeman, Montana, inspired by his time at Gibson as well as the many vintage instruments he has had the privilege to repair. Pretty awesome that we have such a talented luthier literally blocks away from Acoustic Life Studios. Pretty cool. And he makes some damn good instruments. In fact, he was featured on a previous episode of Acoustic Tuesday. If you want to check that out, just go to acousticlife.tv. You'll be able to find the review of Kevin Kopp guitars and learn a little bit more about Kevin Kopp. So that's it, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Acoustic Tuesday episode number 66 is in the books, but let's take a sneak peek into next week to see what's going to happen on Acoustic Tuesday episode number 67. Next week on Acoustic Tuesday, you're going to learn about a lesser-known guitar manufacturer's history, some uber-comfy guitar straps for you to check out. Those may or may not be on the holiday guide. I'm just saying, I don't know. And a band that holds old-time music in high regard, but brings their own twists and turns to it. I'm actually going to go see them next week, so I'll be able to give you the full-blown report. Anyways, I want to thank you all again for joining us today on Acoustic Tuesday, episode 66. We thank you for your time. We thank you for your guitar geekiness. Don't forget to catch Acoustic Tuesday every Tuesday at 10 a.m. Mountain Time. You can catch it on YouTube, and of course, for your Acoustic Tuesday fix in between Tuesdays, go to AcousticLife.tv, where you can do a deep dive on anything I've ever featured on Acoustic Tuesday. Learn more about it, watch bonus videos, find those little Easter eggs, and of course, use those buy links. If you so happen to want to purchase any of the products, we pass all of the percentage of the sale on to Guitars for Vets as a donation on behalf of all of you guitar geeks. So, from Noah, from myself, us guitar geeks here, to you guitar geeks there, thank you so much for joining us today. Have a great week, and we'll see you next Tuesday on Acoustic Tuesday. Cheers to you guys. Take care.